So, suppose we are having here the Lenz law is not valid. Then the induced current flows through the coil in the direction opposite to one directed by the Lenz law. The resulting force of the magnet makes it to move faster and faster, and the magnet gains the speed, and hence the kinetic energy without expending an equivalent amount of particular energy. This set up the particular motion or perpetual motion of the machine, violating the law of conservation of energy. Thus, the law, that means Lenz law, is valid, and it is the consequence of the law of conservation of the energy. So we have to understand that the Lenz law is in accordance with the particular conservation of energy also. Okay, so here we are going to understand the another topic now. We have studied that how the Faraday's laws are there, how the Lenz law is explaining the direction of the particular current induced inside the coil. Now we are going towards moving towards another topic, that is called as a motional EMF from the Faraday's law. Okay, so what is meant by the motional EMF and how to calculate it from the Faraday's law? Sometimes this question is asked in this format for 3 marks, and the same question, motional EMF, also is asked from the Lorentz force. So there are 2 types of derivations by which we can find out motional EMF. But first of all, let us understand regarding the Faraday's law. Okay, so this diagram is shown, and you can see that in this particular case you can have the magnetic field, which is cross field, and it is a uniform magnetic field. Okay, so we have to find out the induced EMF by the change of the area of the coil linked with the magnetic field. Okay, now what is motional EMF? Because we have studied induced EMF, where the coil was stationary and the magnet was moving. And now here we are going to have the magnetic field, crossed magnetic field is constant, isn't it? And we are moving the conductor through that particular magnetic field. And that's what the induced EMF inside the rod or inside the conductor is called as a motional EMF, because it is produced due to the motion of that particular conductor into that magnetic field. Okay, so this is called as a motional EMF. Now in this diagram we are going to consider the particular conductor PQ, which is having length L. Okay, now it is free to move on the U-shaped conducting rails. That means this rod PQ, I can move it on this particular frame, isn't it? Okay, now that is situated in the uniform and time independent magnetic field B. Okay, directed normally into the plane, and that's what shown by the cross letter, isn't it? The conductor PQ is moved moved towards the particular inward, we can say that inward, with the speed V. Suppose we are going to move this particular conductor in this direction with the speed V, isn't it? Now when the conductor slides towards left, the area of the rectangular loop PQRS goes on decreasing, isn't it? So PQRS, if I am going to move it towards it, the area of the loop goes on decreasing. This decreases the magnetic flux linked with the particular conductor, isn't it? This decreases the magnetic flux linked with this particular closed loop also. Hence, the EMF is set up in this particular rod PQ, because of which the induced current flows in the circuit along the path PQRSP. And the direction of the induced current can be determined by the Fleming's right hand rule. Okay, which is stated in the next session. So afterwards we are going to study about the Fleming's right hand rule. So let us go for finding out the motional EMF particular formula. Suppose a length x, this is the x is the length of that particular loop which lies inside the magnetic field at any instant of time t. Then the magnetic flux linked with the rectangular loop PQRS is given by, we have studied that phi is equal to BA. Okay, and now area of the loop, this complete loop, is now L into X. So instead of A, I will write down BLX. Okay, now according to Faraday's law, because this is the formula for the flux we have said. Now according to the Faraday's law, we have studied that E is equal to minus d phi by dt. Okay, so I will take it here, minus d by dt of phi is nothing but blx. Okay, so suppose we are going to find out this value, that is differentiation. So obviously E is equal to, we have here minus b l, this is going to be remaining constant, only x value changes as you go on moving inward by this particular conductor, isn't it? So here E is equal to minus b l into dx by dt. So differentiation is only for the x, because x is going to change. Okay, now therefore we can say that E is equal to BLV. Now why I have taken E is equal to BLV, where this magnetic, where this negative sign has lost. Okay, so let us say that dx by dt is equal to minus V. Dx by dt is equal to minus V, because the velocity V is in the decreasing direction of x, because x is decreasing, isn't it? So as soon as I am going to move this rod towards this, x is going to change, you can observe. Okay, so when x is going to change, it is going to decrease. So as it is decreasing magnet, decreasing distance, so that is again, it is minus, isn't it? So velocity is considered to be minus v, and this minus v and this minus sign goes on continuously having the effect that E is equal to blv. Okay, so I'll write down here dx by dt is equal to minus v, because velocity v is in the decreasing direction. Of x. Therefore, this induced EMF BLV is called as motional EMF, because it is generated due to the motion of the conductor kept in the magnetic field, isn't it? So that's what, this is the formula of the motional EMF, E is equal to BLV, which is we have deduced it from the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So as we have found out the value of the particular electro, that is EMF BLV, then we must know what is the direction of that particular current flowing through that coil. Okay, and direction of the generated current is given by the Fleming's right hand rule. So we have studied that force on a current carrying conductor when kept in the magnetic field is given by the Fleming's left hand rule, and generation or creation of the current in the particular conductor kept in the magnetic field is considered as a Fleming's right hand rule. So what is Fleming's right hand rule? If we stretch the thumb and the first two fingers of our right hand mutually perpendicular direction, if forefinger points in the direction of B, then thumb is in the direction of the motion of the conductor, and central finger points in the direction of the induced current in the conductor. So we can have here, this is the direction of the magnetic field, forefinger magnetic field. Okay, thumb shows the direction of the motion of the conductor, then the middle finger shows the direction of the induced current. So by this method we can find out the current which is produced inside the coil is in this direction. So you can see here the direction of the current is from P, Q, R, S, P. We have applied here the law that is called as the Fleming's right hand rule. So based on this concept only, the generator principle is considered, isn't it? Because specially Fleming's right hand rule is used for explanation of the another concept that is called as a generator. AC generator, DC generators are all based on this particular concept. Thank you.